It's one of the moments of the year so far in collegiate sports in the 2023-2024 academic year. Nebraska women's volleyball hosting a match inside the school's football stadium and drawing over 92,000 fans, the spectacle making headlines across the country. Now one college team in Chicago is going to have a similar opportunity coming up in October. It's one that was born about a year ago from a scrimmage that nobody even saw.
Last year, DePaul and Iowa played a closed-door scrimmage right here in Sullivan McGrath-Phillips Arena and Sullivan Athletic Center. And the score was 96-92. Nobody watched. I mean, it was a closed-door scrimmage, so nobody could watch. And at the end, Caitlin Clark had a triple-double.
And after watching that closed contest, Blue Demons head coach Doug Bruno had a thought.
And Lisa Bluter and I shake hands and kind of sit around commiserate and say, it's just a shame nobody saw this.
So DePaul and Iowa women's basketball came up with an idea to change that with something that is now allowed in college athletics.
And the rule is starting to change. I think schools are figuring out if you just give the money to charity, you can play it publicly.
The Hawkeyes had one organization that worked for them.
Iowa football is unique because it's a children's hospital that overlooks Kinnick Stadium. And it's at the end zone, one of the end zones of Kinnick is a children's hospital.
The tradition is for fans and players to wave at that hospital at the nearly 70,000-seat stadium. So as long as the Hawkeyes and Blue Demons are playing to raise money for them, why not keep that tradition going in a new way?
Man, playing in front of 15,000 people sure is fun.
So welcome to the crossover at Kinnick.
Playing in front of 70,000 is even better.
Fun to think about, you know, we're trying to prepare.
An Iowa DePaul women's basketball game at the football stadium, set for Sunday, October 15th at 2 p.m. Intriguing for observers and especially coaches and players like guard Anaya Peoples.
This is incredible. I think it's amazing for women's basketball. You know, all of our hard work and dedication. Finally, people are coming out, you know, pack the stands. We're getting a full crowd just to see how hard we work. And it's going to be great competition. I'm anticipating a really good game.
The court will be set up in the north end zone with reserve seats already sold out and the rest in the stadium selling for $5 as hoops goes out into the elements.
I mean, it's just going to be interesting to see how three-point shots and long distance shooting could take place in a outdoor arena. You know, it changes the game and how the game's going to be played.
Indeed, people are curious. There are over 40,000 tickets sold as the event looks to best the previous record crowd for a college women's basketball game. That was set in 2002 when over 29,000 watched Connecticut and Oklahoma battle for the national championship in San Antonio's Alamo Dome.
The most fans I think I've ever, like, we've ever played in front of, you know, in our whole basketball careers. But I'm excited to see, you know, just the atmosphere, how it gets loud. I mean, hopefully we have a lot of DePaul fans out there, you know, not just Iowa.
But the biggest benefit for Bruno and Peoples is the continued growing exposure for women's basketball and women's sports itself.
Getting people to watch women play basketball is really part of it's a major part of the mission. Is to get the normal fan, get the sports fan to appreciate women's athletics.
Women's basketball is on the rise, you know, over these last few years. And I think this is just a great event. It's a charity event as well, you know, just to bring people out there and show them, you know, women can play too, women can hoop too. And we have a lot we can bring to the game and the exposure is gonna be, you know, incredible for us.
Now you can read more about the DePaul Iowa women's basketball game at Kinnick Stadium that's coming up in October in the story below or WGNTV.com. Larry Hawley, WGN News Now.